Welcome back friends to the channel Life Sciences Studies. Up till we have studied about amino acid structures and their properties in last three lectures. I have provided the link in description. So in this lecture number 4, we will be discussing about how these amino acids individually in chain creates a three-dimensional structure in proteins, because we know that chain of amino acid have no use. But when this chain gets folded into some three-dimensional structure, then only that chain or protein is useful. So our focus mainly on the secondary structure in proteins. In that we will study about alpha helixes and beta sheet. In alpha helixes we will discuss mainly about 3.613 helix and 310 helix, and in beta sheet we will study about parallel beta sheet and anti-parallel beta sheet. Most importantly, the Ramachandran plot in which these secondary structures are located. And we will see how to plot a Ramachandran plot and how to locate the secondary structure in Ramachandran plot. I am sure after watching this lecture, your perspective about protein structure will be very clear, and I hope you will enjoy this video. So without wasting too much time, let's begin our lecture number 4.
When we say an organism, which is made up of different organs are made up of different tissues, and these tissues are the product of cells. We often call cell as a unit of life. If you think about a single cell, a single eukaryotic cell in this case, which is composed of 70% of water and 30% of different chemicals. These chemicals are nothing but macromolecules. In macromolecules, a protein shows a 15% share, means half percent share is taken by proteins. That's why it is very essential to know about these proteins' diversity, how they function, and for proper function they require proper structure. That's why this lecture number 4 is dedicated to understand how these protein gets their proper structure. These proteins have been categorized at different levels, such as primary structure, secondary structure, tertiary structure, and quaternary structure. In this lecture number 4, we will be focused on the secondary structures in proteins. In lecture number 2nd and 3rd, we have seen that amino acids are interconnected by means of peptide bond. These amino acids are in chain format, produces a polypeptide chain. But this polypeptide chain is of have no use unless it gets folded into a particular three-dimensional structure. And the folded three-dimensional structure is known as protein. And this protein is functional. The polypeptide chain is of having no use, we can say. But the when chain fold itself to produce three-dimensional structure, that folded structure is functional. When we say a unique three-dimensional protein is a product of linear or polypeptide chain, then question arises, how this chain result into this 3D protein structure? To achieve this three-dimensional structure, each amino acid in polypeptide chain will have to perform its role. They perform their role by interacting with water, by forming hydrogen bonds with each other, and by showing other interactions. Most importantly, each amino acid shows a role of geometry in formation of this three-dimensional structure. So what is geometry? Let's focus on geometry first. To measure a distance, we will require only two points, such as in this diagram, point A and B are separated, and only the distance can be derived from these two points. But to count an angle, we will require three different points, such as in this diagram, A, B, C are three points in which AB and BC shows only distance between them, but we can derive angle between AB and BC. So by using 3 points we can derive the angle, and the third point in geometry is a dihedral angle, which is very important and will be required further in our lecture discussion. The dihedral angle is an angle between two planes. So what is angle between two planes? Let's understand this by using 4 points. Point A, B, C and D are shown in this figure, and we know that one plane can be defined by using 3 points. So in this case, A, B, C shows one plane and B, C, D shows another plane. So we have two planes here, but the angle between these two planes is known as a dihedral angle. I will request you to understand this because we will require this information to derive Ramachandran plot. So let's talk about dihedral angles with respect to amino acids in polypeptide chain. A given image shows amino group, alpha carbon atom, carboxylic carbon, again amino group, again alpha carbon, again carboxylic group, again amino group. What it indicates? It indicates it is a chain of amino acid which are interconnected by means of peptide bonds. So we are applying dihedral angle rule for this chain of amino acids. When we select 4 atoms in a chain and draw a plane using first 3 atoms and second plane using second 3 atoms, you will see an overlapping section. This is an overlapping section, is a dihedral angle which is known as psi angle, which is located between carboxylic carbon and alpha carbon atom. When we shift a frame for next 4 atoms and draw first plane selecting 3 atoms and second frame selecting another 3 atoms, the overlapping section will result a peptide bond which is a second dihedral angle, is known as omega angle. And by repeating the same experiment for next 4 points, you will see the overlapping region of two planes shows third dihedral angle, which is a phi angle, which is between a amino group and alpha carbon atom. In this way, we have derived 3 dihedral angles. The first one was a psi angle, which was the between carboxylic group and alpha carbon atom. The second one was omega angle, which was between carboxylic group of one amino acid and amino group of second amino acid. And third dihedral angle is a phi angle, which is between a amino group and alpha carbon atom. So when we say a primary structure, which is nothing but a chain of amino acid, when we consider only 2 amino acids which are connected by 1 peptide bond, it is known as dipeptide. When 3 amino acids with 2 peptide bonds, it is known as tripeptide. When 4 amino acids, it is a tetrapeptide. And when chain contain around 20 amino acids, it is known as oligopeptide. And when amino acid numbers are more than 25, then it is known as a polypeptide. It is about a primary structure. In all cases, the polypeptide will always start with amino terminus and always end with a carboxyl terminus. And in geometry point of view, the amino acids which are in chain are not in linear fashion as shown in this figure. They will always show some zigzag pattern, and this zigzag pattern is a product of phi and psi angle in amino acids. If you see carefully in this pattern, the alpha carbon atom in amino acids are oriented in opposite direction. Alpha carbon in first amino acid is facing downward, where the alpha carbon in second amino acid facing upward. This conformation in amino acids is known as trans conformation, and which is always present in polypeptide chain. They will never occur in cis conformation, where the alpha carbon are oriented in same direction. So the amino acids are always oriented in trans conformation. Please remember this. Let's discuss about a secondary structures in proteins which are very very important, in which we will mainly focused on alpha helix and beta sheet. So let's begin with an alpha helixes first. We will be discussing mainly about 3.613 helix and 310 helix in upcoming discussion. But before going in detail, let's understand about what do you mean by a helix. We know that traditional telephones receiver contain a coiled wire. This wire is nothing but a spiral structure or helical structure. The helix is of 360 degree turn, which is a circle. So the amino acids which are involved get bend itself to give this 360 degree turn. They contributes in turn by bending within. This bending is reflected in their phi and psi angle, as we will see in detail. First, we will discuss about a case of 3.613 helix. The name 3.613 is given because the amino acids which are involved in this structure are responsible for each 100 degree turn. So if you divide 360 by 100 degree, you will see the result of 3.6, means complete 3 amino acids and 0.6 portion of 4th amino acid is required for complete 360 degree turn. That's why the name 3.6 is given. And what is 13? If you count the atoms which are present in complete circle, you will find the number 13. So 3.613 helix is reasonable by above explanation. Let's see which points you need to remember about 3.613 helix. This helix occurs in right-handed orientation manner, which is point number one. The second point shows the phi and psi angle values about this helix. These values are reflection of bending of amino acid, where phi angle value is around minus 57 to minus 60 degree, and psi angle value is around minus 47 to minus 45 degree. These values are very important in order to draw a Ramachandran plot. If you add the values of phi and psi angle, which will come around 100 degree, which indicates that each amino acid bends for 100 degree to help to take complete 360 turn in polypeptide chain. Please notice, these values are in negatives. When negative values in angle, then the orientation of helix will always be in right-handed fashion, which is very basic. If the values are in positive for this angle, the orientation will automatically in left-handed fashion. So let's discuss about these phi and psi angle values with respect to the Ramachandran plot. Ramachandran was a great biochemist who have given huge contribution in biochemistry. So by plotting this graph on graph paper, where we take x and y axis and produces four different quarters. The first quarter is positive positive quarter, second one is positive negative, third one is negative negative, and fourth one is negative positive. This is something which is known to everyone. To draw a plot, we will require values from 0 to 180, and with respect to the quarter, we have assigned the sign, which is plus and minus. On x-axis, they have selected a phi value, and on y-axis, they have selected psi values. So as we have seen, the phi and psi values for alpha helixes, which are shown here, and the location of these values in Ramachandran plot will be in this quarter. And if you take a point of intersection of these values, it will come around this point. So always remember, for right-handed alpha helixes, the location of alpha helix on Ramachandran plot will always be here. This is very favorite question for examiners, and they always ask this question on Ramachandran plot. So please remember this. But when the phi and psi angle values are in positive, then they will produce a left-handed alpha helix structure. And if you are interested to locate left-handed alpha helix in Ramachandran plot, they will occur in this quarter, and point of interception will show the location of alpha helix will be here. So please remember the location of left-handed and right-handed alpha helixes with respect to the Ramachandran plot. And when you notice the hydrogen bonding pattern between amino acids within polypeptide chain, you will find the first amino acid create hydrogen bonding with fifth amino acid. The carboxylic group of first amino acid will form hydrogen bonding with amino group of fifth amino acid. You will see the second amino acid shows hydrogen bonding with sixth amino acid. Likewise, third amino acid will create hydrogen bonding with seventh amino acid, and fourth amino acid will create hydrogen bonding with eighth amino acid. So you can say that I plus 4 fashion of hydrogen bonding is in this type of alpha helix. Generally, these alpha helixes are around 20 to 30 amino acid in their length. If you notice that after taking a complete one turn where 3.6 amino acids are required, the height of the helix or the pinch is around 5.4 angstrom. These values are you need to remember. So after 3.6, 13 helix, we have 310 helix. So the name indicates that the three amino acids are involved to take complete 360 degree turn. So it indicates that each amino acid bends for 120 degree within itself to create such structure, and these three amino acids contributes their 10 atoms. That's why 310 helix name is given to this structure. It's as simple as that. As like 310 helix, we have pi helix also. The pi value, you know, that 3.14. On that basis, the name pi is given. But for our exam point of view, it is important for you to know about 3.613 helix, because most questions are based on that topic. So the question is, why cell would produce these types of secondary structures? So the significance or importance of these secondary structures, alpha helixes in cell, is they act in DNA binding role, and they also involve in protein channels which are situated on membrane. We will see in later classes detail about their functions. So the next secondary structure is a beta sheet in proteins. Beta sheets, as their name indicates, that they appear in planar conformation, in plane. Amino acid chains are aligned in next to each other, so they create hydrogen bond between them, and they result into the planar structure formation. And it is expected that the amino acids in plane would show the phi and psi angle near to the 180 degree. 180 degree means nothing but a plane. And you will see the values falls near to the 180, but not exactly 180, because there is still a zigzag pattern in a sheet. This zigzag pattern is a result of phi and psi angle values, but you have to remember that the phi angle value is negative and psi angle value is positive. Phi angle value is around minus 130 degree and psi angle value is around plus 120 degree. So if you use these values to locate beta sheets in Ramachandran plot, you will see the location of beta sheet on basis of phi and psi angle value will fall in this quarter, and point of interception will show the location of beta sheet in Ramachandran plot will be here. These beta sheets are again of two different types based on the orientation of amino acid chain involved in beta sheet. So from following figure, you can find the amino terminus and carboxyl terminus orientation. If they are in same direction, then the structure is known as parallel beta sheet. And if the structures are in opposite orientation, then it is known as anti-parallel beta sheet. You can notice that in parallel beta sheets, the hydrogen bonding pattern is somewhat tilted, and in anti-parallel beta sheets the hydrogen bonding pattern is straight. And one point I would like to add here is that the anti-parallel beta sheets are more stable as compared to the parallel beta sheets. This is something informative, that to form anti-parallel beta sheets, prolyl amino acids plays important role by producing kinks in a protein. Kink means sharp turn, U-turn, where the two proline amino acids are attached side by side to result in 180 degree turn in a polypeptide chain. So the points we need to remember about beta sheets are that the orientation of amino acid chain decides whether they are in parallel or anti-parallel conformation. Then the hydrogen bonding in anti-parallel is more stable than parallel beta sheets. A zigzag pattern in beta sheets is a result of phi and psi angle, positive psi and negative phi angles. On that basis, we have seen the location of beta sheet in Ramachandran plot, and significance of these beta sheets in protein is that these beta sheets form clips and they also involve in binding, as well as these beta sheets are never remain in plane format. They create barrel, and these barrels are generally occur in a membrane and produces pores which are involved in many exchange matters.
So the lecture number 4 was about secondary structure in proteins, and we studied about alpha helices and beta sheet with respect to the dihedral angle and use of these dihedral angles to locate these secondary structures in Ramachandran plot. I have studied various books and collected this information and joined them to make you understand about this complex concept, and I am sure you must have enjoyed this video. And in next lecture, in lecture number 5, we will study about tertiary structure and quaternary structure in proteins. If you really enjoyed this video, please click on like button, and I really request you to subscribe my channel and share this video so the knowledge will spread among the students. Thank you very much for your time. We will meet again in next lecture. Take care. Bye. Thank you.